They say that the first step is admitting that you have a problem. But like, the first step to what exactly? To healing? To recovery? I never quite knew what. What I did know was that it was an important first step. I mean, it sounds simple, but it took me a while to get to step one, you know? I ignored the initial signs at first. The sleepless nights, the stress, the hair loss, the breakup. I was lashing out to people I loved, and I was loving people I didn't even know. God, I was so blinded, I couldn't even see what I was becoming. I don't really see my undergrad friends anymore. They say that I've changed. Can you believe that? My old roommate slipped a flyer for this session under my door. At first I was like, so angry at him. Like, is this what you think of me? Are you serious? I couldn't believe the dude's nerve. See? Not even close to step one. Pure denial. What was the tipping point? I fought off three ECHA security guards in the lab after hours just to finish a prep on the benchtop. Woke up laying naked in a cold sweat wearing nothing but a gown on the floor of Sherry's office. I got out, but it cost me a small fortune in kit fees. Yeah, you could say rock bottom hit me pretty hard. And that's when I knew. I have to take the first step and just admit it. I am a dental student.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dr. Kellner. Where was I going with that? Welcome back to Dental Students Anonymous. Did you all find parking okay? Great. Now, if you'd all join me in a moment of silence, followed by our serenity prayer. Dentistry,
give us the grace to accept with serenity the knowledge that preventative care is the best option, but will make us no money. The courage to sell people implants, and the wisdom to know when to refer. Amen.
Thank you all for coming. Now, I've seen most of you come in, but has anyone seen Cody?
He graduated.
Okay, everyone, let's get started then.
Is there an attendance sheet?
No, this is not a mandatory session.
Yeah, baby!
Now, I see we have a new member here today. Would you care to share a little bit about yourself?
Sure. My name's Case.
And?
And I'm a dental student.
Hi, Case.
Thank you for joining us, Case. As you know, this is a safe place for those people who identify as dental students. By being here, you're taking an important first step towards healing. Now, shall we carry on from where we left off last time? I believe it was William or Will's turn to speak.
I actually go by Mark, and I'm a dental student.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, Mark.
But I wasn't always, I was an electrician for 6 years before all this. I was a different man.
On the campus of one of Canada's leading universities.
There's a prep outline in the hallway outside. It took Dr. Kilisoff and I 2 years to do this preparation, and I'm hoping that one of you will prep it by the end of the term.
The most gifted hands to ever enter its classrooms.
This is correct. Who did this?
Are the ones changing its light bulbs. Meet Will Spackman, who goes by Mark.
Someone going through this resume of yours, assault, theft, daughters, theft from daughters.
I've spoken to your employer, and he has agreed to release you under my supervision.
Really?
But you have to meet with a dentist twice a week.
For the first time in his life, he's about to meet his match.
So how many dentists did you come to before me?
31. This man's genius is unparalleled. I need someone who can get through to him.
Let the learning begin.
Some people can never believe in themselves.
I went on a date last week. You going out again?
I don't know. this girl's like, you know, beautiful. She's smart, she's fun, she's like perfect right now. I don't want to ruin that.
Maybe you're perfect right now. Maybe you don't want to ruin that.
Until someone believes in them.
Have you talked to him about his future as a specialist?
Give him time to figure out what he wants.
This man has that gift. Can you imagine if G.V. Black, the father of dentistry, had given that up just to have a family and career?
I can't learn anything about you unless you talk to me in proper dental terms.
Hey, you're sitting on a winning lottery ticket here.
You any procedure you want, you're bound by nothing.
Man, I'd do anything to have what you got.
And some never know how much they can have.
I love you.
Until they discover how much they can give. Goodwill's Pac-Man, but he goes by Mark.
So yeah, a second career.
Thank you so much, Mark. Now moving on, sir. Is there someone behind the curtain? Sir!
I've been spotted.
Not sure I've ever seen you in Ekka. Don't make me call campus security.
Ma'am, I hate to blow my cover still, sir, but I'm a private investigator. I'm investigating thousands of dollars in missing kid fees. They're gone from your pockets. Trace. I broke into the vital source mainframe, but with no avail. It seems to run on a different energy source. Kid fees! Where do they go?
Okay, calm down, sir. Maybe someone here can help you. Let's take a floss break, everyone.
Kit fees? How can I even begin to explain kit fees?
Kit fees are flawless.
I heard kit fees bought Dr. Major 2 Fendi purses and a silver Lexus.
I hear our kit fees insure Dr. Kula's good eye for $10,000.
One time, I had to pay $15,000 in kit fees.
And they told me no more 245 birds.
One time, kit fees bankrupted me. It was awesome.
I need to find the missing 245 birds now.
Susan, are you okay? Talk to us, Susan, what happened?
So many germs.
It was just a normal dental procedure.
You didn't see what I saw?
post-traumatic infection control protocol disorder. Happens every year.
Shame.
Moving on now, next on the agenda is, oh my, Kathy Cousy. I'm sorry, you startled me. I didn't see you sitting there so quietly.
Sorry? I just came here to get some support. I made a huge decision, and it was a tough pill to swallow.
Tell us more.
The angst all began as I was finishing up pre-med. I had it all. Clinical experience, perfect grades, wholesome extracurriculars, and my last name. But I had to make a choice.
Let me tell you why you're here. You're here because you know something. Like overhang between your molars, driving you mad. Do you know what I'm talking about?
The matrix band.
Do you want to know what it is? Unfortunately, no one can be told what it is. You need to see it for yourself. This is your last chance. After this, there's no going back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up and your life is taken over by medicine. You think that life will be good, but you will struggle with 8 more years of school and have no life in the future. You take the red pill and you stay in Dentland. I'll show you how deep this proximal box goes. And remember, all I'm offering is a perfect career or medicine.
That was disgusting.
All right, I'll give you a second chance. You really can't go wrong. Third red pill?
You poor thing.
You have no idea.
Oh yeah, you're the one. The one that left med behind.
Thanks, it's good to be here. And if you guys have time, do you guys mind checking out my project?
Moving on. Yes, with the hat.
Yo, it's a little cast up from Pre-Med 101.
Highest carving score of his year. First draft picked. Real hopeful.
What happened?
I just miss being good.
It all starts with this student here, Sean Wasson. Holy hell, could this guy dance with a soap? And he could put a square flute on that son of a gun too. He's 100% pure, natural carver. So he ends up going number 2 overall, and Alberta grabs him.
Woo! Number 1, baby. I'm number 1.
Fourth week into the semester. It's the first hand in. Bam! Dr. Mark the Shark Wright.
Nice mark, eh?
Suffers his first failing grade. Lucky he wasn't killed. Then he comes back. He scared cuspless out there. The pressure's starting to mount on this kid, and he can't hack it.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
He's missing labs, hanging with the wrong people. There are rumors, and it starts to add up. So that summer, he says he wants a trade. They send him down to the States. He's a nobody now.
I'm just a number now. Bench number 3.
Thank you so much for sharing bench number 3. Now, Case, if you're comfortable, we ask that our new members share their story with the rest of the group.
I'm not sure where to start.
When did you first know, Case?
It got to that point where, as soon as I swiped my card into SimLab and heard that ring, I just knew it was going to be a rough day.
Oh, no.
Look, everyone! Lotte's got himself a holler!
I ignored one from Terra once. It was horrible.
Case and Lotte! How dare you waste those teeth! I'm absolutely disgusted! Your bench is now facing an inquiry upstairs and it's entirely your fault! If you put another toe out of line, there will be no more teeth for you! Oh, and Kira, dear, congratulations on always keeping your bench clean. Terra and I are so proud. 11:15 a.m.
me, you filthy cavity! Baby, I love you. I'm sorry. Come on, baby, come here. Come here.
Ali, bro, I need your help.
Man, I told you. You gotta tag her in a few memes, then you slide in the DMs.
No, not about that. I'm going to the north side. You're the only one in the class that has a certain quality.
Hot dog, it's almost fishing weather.
Wow, that's bonkers.
Yeah.
I understand. Follow me.
At this point, my only option was to look for teeth elsewhere. I knew a guy who used to help out a cousin of mine. I got the pickup location. I was familiar with the area, but it was always a scary place to go.
Bro, you know where we're going.
Yeah, I got a map right here.
Yep, looks legit. Let's go.
Hey man, you know our dogs are twins, and you got insurance and I didn't get insurance? Well, you see Spot, he's not doing too good, okay? And I was just wondering,
I don't have time for this.
Okay.
Everybody knows that's unethical anyways.
Yeah, I was thinking that too.
Alright man, just stay here and watch my back if anything goes down.
Touching my car, buddy. Back up.
Is that bulk film? My cousin contacted you. I need some stuff.
Your cousin, eh?
Yeah.
Are you a Lotte?
Yeah.
I know your cousin. I don't know you. You don't look like a dental student to me.
Honestly, ask me anything. I'm desperate. I need some stuff.
Oh, yeah? All right. You part of the crimps?
The crimps? No. Why?
No, you doorknob the crimps. Toffelmeyer crimps. Northside Dental Gang. First things first, what's the worst thing that the class of 2020 had to witness last year?
Easy, it was a Med 2020 MMI video.
Alright, wise guy, what's a kickback?
I don't know.
It's okay, neither do the 2021s. Alright, final question. What's a password for CPR, bro? Ask the 5 people.
Don't worry, man, you're gonna be a great dentist.
Alright, get out of my way. What can I do for you? You need a hoe band?
No.
How about a dental dam? Some KY jelly? How about some protection for a late night drilling session with your dexture?
No, man, that's gross.
How about some LLC? I just sold some to that dental student right there.
We're not.
No, man.
All right. How about some victory t-shirts that the 2019s made for Dentween? Dirt cheap and never worn.
No, man. I think I may just grab a few teeth. Mostly a bunch of 3-6s.
All right, man. Definitely. I'm gonna need your right one, though.
My right what?
Tuition is rising. Kid fees are so damn high. I don't think you're gonna be able to pay me, bro. I'm gonna need your kidney. I didn't really pass renal, so I don't know where it is. But I'm sure you have two somewhere. Give me it or get stepping.
Case, we've all been there.
Except for me, first year was like not even hard, guys.
Are you serious?
I don't know.
I struggled everything. I have no friends. Oh my
guys,
god.
Wait.
Make cones.
Remember all the great times we've had? And I know there's been some rough times too. Sometimes we're nervous because we switched careers or we're in a lot of debt and we're not naturals, but that's okay because we're all in this together, right? Remember OWeek? I've never felt so surrounded by strong, kind, and like-minded people. I was worried about making a single friend, but I made 31 and I feel like dentistry is a whole family now. We go for food,
celebrate good times and get irritated by each other, and we work it out. We'll all get through this together.
Hey, I was doing just fine before I met you. Drank too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, should tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. No breaks your heart, I moved to a city in a broke down car in 4 years, no calls, and now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar, and I can't stop. No,
well, I showered for this, so I'm glad you got it.
So baby, pull me closer in your backseat.
Yeah.
You don't want to answer our questions?
Well, I feel like they're going to be stupid questions, Kelsey.
Okay, you're not working. What advice do I have for the incoming class? To have fun. You're in it for 4 years, and the people you're with right now will be there for the rest of your degree, and after that, probably lifelong friends.
Just come in, chill.
Never trust anyone in your class when they say they don't study for tests.
I don't know advice, man! My advice for you guys is to stay clear, case.
It's an adjustment from undergrad. You're not competing against everyone, you're here to learn.
A group of people that are doing the same thing, and they're so supportive, and I think that was really helpful.
Don't forget to take care of yourself. Whether it's your own time, take your free days off, do what you love.
Don't forget your friends. Make sure you make time for them. It's definitely doable. It'll seem overwhelming, but you definitely have the time.
Make friends with somebody who's more skilled than you are.
Realize that you're not always going to be the best, and that you have to accept that sometimes you're going to have to fall down before you can get up and learn how to get up again.
Hang out with your friends and your classmates. Otherwise, you'll be known as a lame class. So.
What did I do when I found out I got in?
I was really happy because I thought, yes, my parents will disown me.
So I checked my email, I read the email, and I started crying. I had 2 minutes to cry, and then I had to go back to teaching kindergartners in a summer day camp.
It was a pretty wild moment, and my lunch break turned into just me calling everybody I knew.
I gently woke him up, and I was like, Dad, open your eyes. And he was like, oh, what? And I was like, I'm gonna be a dentist. And then he could hardly get up, and then he was like, oh, help me up.
My favorite memory would be the Christmas party that we had at Jenny's house.
The Mexico trip was pretty fun. Yeah.
Tequila!
It would be our class Christmas party at Jenny's house.
We had the class fest. That was very emotional for me. As a Muslim, we fast for Ramadan, and we had like a group effort where the class would fast with me and my other Muslim classmates, and we went out to break our fast together, and I was so touched by my classmates and by the effort they put in.
You gotta repeat it back.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to repeat. Did I or did I ever have a crush on MC? My red face probably gives you the answer.